Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytubes.com. In this video, I'm going to discuss and demonstrate how to package your InDesign project. So what exactly is packaging? Okay, so imagine you want to share your finished document with another designer, a printer, or simply archive your project away. Simply sending the InDesign file will not work. An InDesign document can contain lots of exterior content, like image links and fonts. Not everything is contained inside the document. There is a feature in InDesign which allows us to create an entirely new folder on our computer which will contain all the links and font references neatly together. This can then be sent to another designer and they will be able to open the document perfectly. Also, if you have links inside your document from various places on your computer, this can be a way to create a neat and tidy folder on your computer. So let's take a look at how this can be done. So here I am in InDesign, and here I have the brochure document open we created earlier in the course. If you have been following along with this course, be sure to open your brochure document. Though if you're new to this course and wish to follow along, you can get access to the InDesign file in the project folder. Link is in the description. Remember, you will also have to install the fonts when you open the document. That can also be found in the project folder. So as I scroll down, we can see that this document contains lots of images. If we come over to the links panel, we can see we have several links contained in this document. Also, we have a particular font installed. So the one thing you need to be sure of before packaging your document is that no links are broken and you have no errors in your document. If I focus on the bottom of the screen, we have our pre-flight signal. This is here to communicate to you the status of your document. Currently, we can see this is set to green. This means there are no errors in this document. If, however, this was red, then this would indicate that there is something wrong with the document, for example, a broken link or overset text. If this is the case, then we would have to rectify any errors inside the document first. So once we have the green light, we can package the document. So to package the document, first press Command S to save the current document. Then come up to File, scroll down and select Package. Upon click, the Package menu will appear. The first screen is a summary of your document, fonts, links, colors, and so on. On the left, we can click on other options to take a closer look, such as fonts. Here it states what fonts you have used and the status of them. Same again with links, colors, and so on. So once happy, press the Package button down on the bottom right of the menu. Upon click, you will be greeted with the printing instructions. This is where you can add details about yourself for the receiver of the folder later. Should you wish, you can enter your details here, though on this occasion I'll just click Continue. Now upon click, up will pop a window asking you where you want to save your packaged folder. So starting at the top, you can name your package. I'll just call this Brochure. Now you can save this anywhere, but I'll save this into my project folder, into the package folder. So below we have a list of options. Now we are about to create a neat package with everything needed to open this document elsewhere. Here we have the option to include fonts, links, an IDML file, and even a PDF. Now sometimes you may wish to send your document but without the fonts. If the person who is going to receive the package does not possess the license to the fonts you have used, then you might not want to send them the fonts. For the sake of this tutorial, I will leave this fonts box checked. So currently, I'm using Adobe InDesign CC 2014. In this version, we have the option to also export an IDML file and a PDF. This is a new feature, so if you're using an older version of InDesign, you may not have this. So the IDML file is a backwards compatible file. If you're sending your package document to someone who uses an earlier version of InDesign, well, they will not be able to open your original InDesign file. If you include the IDML file, then they should be able to open up that document. More on this later. Next, we have a PDF. Upon packaging, you can conveniently export a PDF, so whoever receives the package can browse the PDF to see the contents of the document quickly at a glance. Over on the right, you have the option to set the quality of this PDF. For now, I'll leave it set to high quality. Okay, so once I'm happy with the settings, I'll click Package. Upon click, we will get a quick warning about the font licensing. I'll click OK to continue. And upon click, InDesign will now begin to package our new document. Shortly, that will be done. Once finished, I'll press Command W to close the document. So once you have packaged your document, navigate to the location you saved it. So here is my new package document inside my project folder. When you package a document, you create a folder with everything neatly contained. So let's take a look inside. So here we have the IDML file, the InDesign file, the PDF, the document fonts, the instruction file, and the links. So the IDML file is here for people using older versions of InDesign. If I double click this, it will open in InDesign. Next, we have the InDesign file. This is the CC 2014 document compatible with my version, and this too will open in InDesign. Next, we have the PDF, and this will give us a preview of the document. Next, we have a document fonts folder, and this contains the fonts used in the document. Next, we have the instructions doc with all the info about the document. And finally, we have a links folder, which contains every link featured in the document. So everything perfectly contained in a neat folder here. So if I wish to send this over to another designer, printer, or simply archive this project away, I can right click, choose compress, I'll create a neat zip file. I'm on a Mac here. If you're using Windows, then you can use WinZip or WinRAR. Once it's created, I can then send this over the internet or archive the project away. Simple. So that's how you can package an InDesign document. A real neat way to stay organized and share your documents with others. So that brings us to the end of this multimedia design course for print. I hope you enjoyed this course. If you were not familiar with the topics covered in this course, I hope you have learned a lot and feel confident to continue with your own projects in future. If you liked the course, hit the like button on my Facebook page. If you'd like to see more videos like this in future, hit the subscribe button. Well, that's it for another video course brought to you by Gareth at tastytutes.com. Thanks for watching. Have fun, guys, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.